presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
I call this a little stubby cigar smallmouth. You say to yourself, what's a stubby cigar smallmouth? Well, it's a stub end of a piece of plastic, a little stick worm. In this case, it's a 5-inch Ocho, a little bit thicker body profile. And I have it tucked up against this little mushroom head. The little mushroom head, you can see it there. I take the scissors right here, and I take my little Ocho. In this case, this is the KBD Magic. So I get the little 5-inch Ocho, get it out there in the back end. So if you got all those pieces of worm in your boat and stuff that are hanging around, don't throw them out, because this little stubby cigar catches bass. So I go about, oh, I'd say 3 inches up, cut it right centered, keep this piece, and that's all you want right there. That's all it is. Simple, peasy, easy. Flat nose, it's pushed up, right up over the hook, down the shaft. Look where that hook comes out too. More than halfway back. Perfect, man. When fish see it, they're gonna eat it. Some big ones down there, man. They're so subtle right now. Wow. So I work it right by the boat. When I come back on each retrieve, I shake always beside the boat, just in case one's falling that I don't see. And sometimes if you're lucky, the fish gods are with you that day, they come turn around and eat it. Oh, Carl! See that? First drop, 6.5 feet of water, it's about 8.5. First drop, it was weight, I leaned back, it's gone. That was a fish.
Wow.
I know where you boys are. Let's see if you pulled my bait down. Did you?
Wow, eh?
Get on their heads. Went from 48 to 49 on the surface. Maybe that sun penetration is helping a little bit. Just enough. And decide to stop looking and eating. I got it rigged on 10-pound fluorocarbon gamma with braid leading down about 15-pound. In this case, I'm using the St. Croix Legend X 6.8 medium power Legend X. This rod, I guarantee you, if a leaf falls near my bait, I'll know. Low profile, Tatula Badaiwa, rig right to the tip. Smooth drag, even though these fish, water temperatures today, looks like we started out up in the corner there, 47. We got about 49. One thing about late spring, it's not about the early bite. Don't worry about getting up early. Don't worry about getting out there and stuff. You gotta figure out how to catch them. And this little power finesse, I call it, this is a powerful little bait, you know? It catches them, but just hop it, pop it, skip it, drop it, let it sit. I'll show you how I work it, and I'll bet you this little thing is gonna catch some smallmouth and inspire you to pick up those little pieces of worm that you normally throw out and use them because they catch bass. Oh, good one. Oh, I missed them. Oh, lordy, lordy. I know where you boys are. Oh, yeah. Carl, hey, Carl. Hey, Carl. Catching bass, Carl. There's spawn bass right there. Look at that. That's why you gotta wear polar glasses, no matter what you're fishing for. With the stubby, hey, with the stubby cigar. You say, what's a stubby cigar? I'm gonna show you folks in a minute what the stubby cigar is. Fishing for cold water, early season smallmouth. Right here. That's what we're talking about. We get serenaded by the woodpecker. Look at that, man. Just a gorgeous first fish of the day, huh? You know, not complaining when it's cold out. It's cold out, man. We had north wind last night and rain for 2 days. But we came up here, look where that little cigar is. What's a cigar? I'll show you. It's part of my Ocho, pushed up. I call it the little stubby cigar. It's pushed back up like this. I'll show you that, how it looks. It's pushed up to the little mushroom head. That's the result right there. Working it slow, But again, you have to wear glasses. I don't care when you come out fishing for whatever. You wear glasses, you will see those shadows. I saw the shadow, we'll put them in there maybe for some pictures. I let them go. Sitting out here in 8 feet of water. They're not doing any business yet. They're thinking about it. The water's only 48 degrees. Let's put them in there, see if we can maybe catch one of his friends and do it. You see, man, what is that, a stubby cigar? That's what I call it. And it's just a little mushroom head, you know, tied directly to a piece of fluorocarbon gamma that's about to 10 pound test. And the little piece of ocho at the back end, pushed up, that's it. Simplest little bait known to mankind right there. A piece of little plastic. I changed from using the white oyster to this KVD magic. And now I catch a fish. He ate it. I'm going to show you the whole deal. But let's see if we can catch one more matching that. And they're not up in that tight stuff where they might be in about 2 weeks' time, 3-4 feet of water. They're out here in 8 and 9, staging, waiting for it to get sunny, waiting for it to get warm, waiting to catch. Let's go. You say you always see me looking down, looking down, looking down. Well, I'm looking for lots of things this time of year. Transitions and stuff, maybe from 6 feet to 7. That's it, just a little bit of a break. Sometimes they're sitting in that little ditch or whatever it is. Or if I see the fish symbols and stuff, you know what it does for me? It gives me confidence, knowing that I'm in the right area. I just gotta fish that little cigar bait nice and slow and tempt these fish, provoke them. And finally, boom. So it's so important. You know, there's a few things I said I wouldn't even fish with. A lot of sonar, Polaroid glasses, trolling motor, and of course the rod and the tackle and stuff, but boy, so, so important. Oh, Carl! Darn! That one went, boom! Look at that bait. See that? When they're subtle, the water's cold, it's almost like they stunt it. Pull it, pull back on it. Not committing. You need a little bit more water temperature. You know, there's other techniques and stuff, drop shotting, maybe a little worm, finesse worms and stuff, but hey man, I wanted to show you the little stubby cigar. It's a good fish, let's see. What are you, Mr. Smallmouth? Looks like you're shaking your head like Mr. Smallmouth. Hey, Mr. Ike. Oh, Mr. Smallmouth. Decent little fish again, look at that, eh? Just decent little fish. Going in a circle. He saw the stubby cigar. I'll bring her on this side. He saw the stubby cigar. He won't eat the stubby cigar. How didn't ya? Look at that hook penetration, eh? Look at that hook penetration. He's good, he's good. Look at that. Watch when you just take that out. Proper hook sets, man, right through the nose, right past the lip. A little bait, man. Just a little bass, but ice cold. I mean ice, ice cold. But that's, hopefully we'll get into some big ones. But that's the deal right there, boys. Go on, here he goes. Just a little bait, just a little bait. But man, oh man. And sometimes when you get like that, they tear it a bit. What I'll do is, instead of throwing it out, I'll take it off like that. Remember, it's just an old piece of plastic anyway. The other side of it, come around, you can recycle it, still catch fish, push it up, and I'm ready to fish again. So let's see on this cold day if I can get a couple more smallmouth deep my little stubby cigar. I'll tell you what's really important, the polarization of these glasses. When you're popping it and stopping it, see how I just twitch like this? I just get their attention. Then I stop it on the bottom. Twitch it like that. You watch your bait all the way back to the boat. Do not take your eyes off looking up. Wow, is that a merganser? No, is that the woodpecker? No, man. Because sometimes you'll see fish just flare. The water temperatures in the high 40s and stuff, they're just not real aggressive. You'll just see them coming turn. Sometimes you can drop down and catch them. With the polarization, looking right through, plus it protects your eyes from the sun's rays, you better be prepared with different tools. But eyewear, very important when you're fishing. Ooh, big one. Got him. Oh yeah, look at the size of that thing, dude. Look at that. Wow. Out there, 7 feet, 6 feet of water. Oh boy. Oh boy, hey. Oh boy. They look so big in the water, don't they? Oh man, gorgeous fish. I thought it was a giant. Just good size, look at what's good size, the ones that eat. Oh man, oh man, oh man. Just gorgeous smallmouth. That one wanted to eat it. Look at, look where he's got it. Wow, hey. Oh yeah, just look at that. How's that for a nice long fish, hey? I thought he was like a giant. Again, a couple of pictures of some fish. Gonna call him out, but boy, oh boy. Gotta love the smallmouth, eh? You know, and the presentation. Little stubby cigar. So I'm gonna let you go. How's that, right? Let's let you go right there. Okay, I'll let you go. Ready? Look at him go. Wow, man. I told you about using the sunglasses, you know? Pitching all around here, just pitching around. I thought I seen one over there. I had two that picked it up. Two, man. And just slowly let go. This one, a few hops and pops in about 6 feet of water, 7 feet, pop. Then I see him turn going back down. I just waited. And this felt a little boop sensation. The rest you saw. Right back up. See if maybe I can catch a couple more fish, then call it an afternoon.
And now it's time for the Xtreme Edge.
Fall smallmouth options. What do you want to do? You know what? There's all kinds of baits. Crank baits, twitch baits, spinner baits, you name it. Rattle baits. But this little bait I want to show you today, I want to use a little football head with a wide setback hook, and I'm going to throw it on that St. Croix. And it's called the Swim Jig Finesse. 7-1 medium heavy with 14-pound gamma edge. Straight fluorocarbon, right to the hook eye, but the little 3.25-inch Rage Swimmer by Strike King. Now, the little football head, I can fish in the weeds, so I can bury the hook. I can texpose it, but when I'm fishing near rocks and points and boulders and stuff like that, this time of year, there is periods where the fish come right in tight, 4 feet, 5 feet to feed. So this little bait, I can cast it out, swim it slow, I can work it on the rocks, bounce it to the weeds, swim it. So there's so many options with this little bait right here. The little football head, jig head, with the Rage Swimmer 3.25, rigged up with the St. Croix, little Daiwa Tatula. I'm ready and rigged to hopefully catch some smallmouth to inspire you to say, you know what, next time you walk by those little football heads, what would I ever use that for? You remember on Xtreme Angler, you saw it. Hey, remember when Carl used that thing, man? Got some good smallmouth. Well, let me back up a sec. I haven't gone out yet. So I'm going out now, so I didn't jinx myself. That's the kind of confidence I have with baits like this. Football head, Rage Swim bait, good rod, good attitude, good lake, good luck. Not in the weed, you know you're not fishing in the right spots. To never curse the weeds, because you know you're doing what you should be doing. Fishing where the fish are. Oh, without a doubt, without a doubt. There's bass here, without a doubt. Yeah, see? Yeah, man. Good one, too. Shallower water. Shallower water. And better bass. Whoa, that's nice fish, man. Nice one to start with the little football with the Rage Swimmer, huh? That's a nice little football, eh? Look at him. Just gorgeous little fish. No giant. Look at the body on these fish. Real football with the football. See that? Right there. Little Rage Swimmer, little 3/16 weighted head. Let's let him go right here, huh? Let's let him go right here. Gonna find one of your 4 or 5 pound buddies. Go on. Now I'm working the baits, okay? Making those pitches 25, 30 feet ahead, all around. Keeping my wits about me, looking for seagulls, looking for loons, looking for fish activity, bait fish, shooting out and stuff like that, because we got real slick, calm conditions here. It's a perfect day, but not the perfect day for smallmouth. So this presentation, we cover the whole water column. So if a fish is up pushing minnows and stuff from the top, he's going to see it, he's going to eat it. So I'm going to fish areas between 3 to 4, 6 to 8, maybe 10 feet deep, but I want to get those areas where there are ambush conditions, where the fish is right on the edge of the rocks, close to the boulders, or right on that cabbage weed. So it's like, it's not a real distinct line. It's just sporadic weed going from 3 to 5 feet, and sporadic weed. They use that. They just go along it. They're not sitting in one spot. They just go along it looking for stuff. They're opportunistic. And when the opportunity comes, they see that little football head with the great swimmer, you know they eat it. Oh boy, look at him, right? Think he's crazy? Look at that one. That one deserves a net, doesn't he? Come here. There you go. That's what we're looking for right there. Edge of the weeds. See? Look where that football is right there. Think that fish wanted that? That's a big smallmouth, boy. That's nice in anybody's books right there. Where's that hook? Oh. There he's right there. Sharp hook, big bass. Take some pictures and let him go, okay? Big, fat smallmouth. Spends more time out of the water. He's thinking about jumping in the boat, but think about the little football head, the fine wire hook, and the great swimmer. Next time conditions get tough, you want to catch fish on a pressured lake, in a tournament, think about it, because this bait catches them any which way on any body of water. So I'm working that bait, pitching out, and I'm just popping it off the bottom. Water's cold, but I still want to get their attention. Hopping it, dropping it. And some of the bites today have been just right, I'd say about 4 inches off the bottom. Boom! And just nothing elaborate, just almost shaking just the rod. So that bait just darts around a little bit, drags on the bottom. If there's any sand and stuff, just mix up the sand. Just causes a commotion. Smallmouth are very inquisitive fish. Sometimes you just get their attention. Even in these really cold conditions, you can get them, trigger them to bite. It's a little stubby cigar. Now basically what I'm doing right here is dissecting. I got the power poles down. Caught a fish right here. So the poles are down, caught the fish. I cast till 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, almost 3 o'clock. And work the same area. Smallmouth, even in springtime, matter, man. They pair up 2, 3, 4. I looked down on my sonar and I seen 2, 3 fish underneath the boat. I guarantee you those fish are the ones that were following that one that was hooked. But they just mosey along. They seem to be sitting in that, it's 7'8" right here. This 8-9 foot little break right here from the shore. So I just dissect that area before I decide to move on. That's why those poles, the shallow water anchor, they're priceless, man. It's all the tools of the trade, man. From the sonar, that I see the fish, rod, line, hook, poles, you name it. A nice solid chain, no weak links. That's how you put fish in the boat, on all the conditions. Not just when they're biting good. Let's try it a bit more out here before we move up a little bit. Do the same thing. Dissect the area, just dissect it. See that? That's a big one too. I think it is. I'll bring him on this side. Oh, he's just a chunker. Look it. He's just a chunker. I popped it a bit. He decided to eat it. Look at that. Gorgeous little fish. Gorgeous little bass. Look where that bait is again, hey? Look where that bait is again, folks. That. Just lift them up. I won't do that to any big fish, but look where that bait is. You see that? That one, he snapped it like a walleye. Going down off the bottom. Watch when I just pop it down. Boink. Out. A little chunker, huh? Little chunker. How about I let you go right over here? Get a clear view of him going over right here, huh? Hey? You ready to go? Go and look at their nose. Just stunted. Looking for eating crayfish and stuff. But boy, oh boy. That's the deal, man. You see a little versatile little baits? Little piece of ocho. You laugh, it seems so easy, but when they introduced stickworms, you know, years ago, people laughed at that, like, what? A little piece of plastic going down this way, you hook it in the center, you use a little black ring and just O-ring and let it fall. And now with the Ned rig, they put a little weighted nail on one side to go down, something like that. It's all about keeping the bait in the zone where the fish are. That's all it is, man, you know? It ain't nothing, you know, scientific about it. You can keep bait a long time in a fish's, you know, strike zone where they're comfortable eating, you're going to catch them. And this little piece of ocho that I call the little stunted cigar is catching fish on a cold spring day. So you learn another technique for cold water smallmouth with a piece of worm. In this case, it's a 5-inch ocho, cut in half, put on the back of a mushroom head, and you're going to catch them when the weather's cold, whether it be spring, summer, or fall. Because we want you to be a better angler. Thanks for watching. I'm going home.
Xtreme Angler has been presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, St. Croix Rods, Strike King Lure Company, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Gamma Fishing Lines, Power Pole. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us. Like us. Follow us. See us.